Hello, so just a quick video to help you find the data if you want a refresher. So open up a web browser, GoGIS is fun, and you're going to be looking for a weekend one zip, and if you click on that once, it should download, and then once it stops blinking, you can click on that once and it should open up, and then if I say extract all files, it'll ask me where I want to put them. And if I go over here and go to my W file, and then I've been here for a while, so I've got it organized by year, and then I've got this GG120 in there, and if I just say OK, it should then, if I say extract, it should bring over 92 items. Well, let's see what it did. So it brought over weekend 1 in 120, and if I double click on it, you'll see that there's a PDF of the that's similar to what's on Canvas, and then there's this GDB that you're not going to really be able to look at it too deeply, but if you open it up, you'll see that's where most of the items come. So that's, don't muck with any of this. Let's just back out of there slowly and shut the door, and we'll look at it in ArcCatalog, which I don't recognize on my pull-down list, so if I slowly start to type it in, it'll give me that option. And ArcCatalog is opening up. So then once ArcCatalog opens up, you'll probably, again, you know, connect a folder and navigate to where you just stuck that thing. Right, so mine's under F16. I'm going to say connect to there. And now there it is. And if I open it up, you'll see that we no longer see the PDF because that's not a file format that ArcCatalog is used to reading, but you can see the cylinder, and what you'll notice is that when we drill into the cylinder, we just get shown these two raster files. And so that's one of the benefits about using ArcCatalog, is it provides basically what you're seeing over here. When we peek into this door, is you're seeing the you're seeing all of the different files that have to work together in order to represent a raster. And what you see here is just kind of the raster, if that makes sense. So this is an effort to hide details from you and facilitate moving these layers around without having to muck with all of the files that are actually coming together to make this layer, if that makes sense. So that's one of the reasons why it's nice to just, once you move the data over to the directory through this Windows Explorer format, from there on, just use ArcCatalog to move and copy and manage your files. Fair enough. And so at this point, I think we got our data and we're ready to roll.